Sputnik. The program that started the space age. Its primary goal was to achieve orbit and demonstrate Soviet technical superiority. Sputnik 1 became the world's first artificial satellite in 1957, a simple act that shocked the world. Sputnik 2 launched the first living creature, the dog Laika, into orbit, demonstrating that a living organism could survive launch and a short time in orbit, even though Laika herself died of overheating within hours. While it included a failed third launch and a final scientific satellite, the program's true legacy was its first two shots, which ignited the space race. Luna. The robotic conquest of the moon. This was a sweeping series of missions that achieved a staggering number of lunar firsts. Luna 1 was the first probe to fly past the moon. Luna 2 was the first to impact it. Luna 3 gave humanity its first ever glimpse of the moon's far side. Luna 9 performed the first robotic soft landing on another world, and Luna 16 was the first to automatically collect a lunar sample and return it to Earth. It was a stunningly successful program that consistently beat the Americans in the early robotic race to the moon. Lunokhod, the first robotic rovers on another world. This program was a stunning technological success, deploying two large, wheeled rovers to explore the lunar surface under remote control from Earth. Lunokhod 1, delivered by the Luna 17 lander, became the first rover on any celestial body, and operated for 10 months, traveling over 10 kilometers. Its successor, Lunokhod 2, was even more advanced, and covered about 39 kilometers across the lunar surface. They were the pioneers of planetary roving exploration. Vostok, the program that put the first human in space. On April 12, 1961, Yuri Gagarin launched aboard Vostok 1 to become a global hero. The Vostok spacecraft was a small, spherical capsule designed for single cosmonauts. The program continued to push boundaries, including the first dual spacecraft flight, and, on its final mission, Vostok 6, carried Valentina Tereshkova into orbit as the first woman in space, cementing its legacy of pioneering human achievement. Voskhod, an incredibly risky, politically driven program to achieve more spectacular firsts. Using heavily modified Vostok capsules, Voskhod 1 carried the first ever multi-person crew into space, a feat only accomplished by removing all safety systems, including spacesuits. On Voskhod 2, Alexei Leonov performed the first-ever spacewalk, a dramatic and nearly disastrous event. This high-risk two-mission program was a stopgap measure, a testament to the Soviet Union's willingness to gamble for prestige in the space race. Venera, the robotic conquest of Venus. While the Soviets struggled at Mars, they were the undisputed masters of Venus exploration. The Venera program was a series of probes designed to survive the planet's hellish atmosphere. It achieved numerous firsts: the first to enter another planet's atmosphere, the first to make a soft landing on another planet, and the first to transmit images and sound from the surface of another world. It remains one of the most successful planetary exploration programs in history. Vega, a bold, dual-purpose mission to Venus and Halley's Comet. The twin Vega 1 and 2 probes first flew to Venus, where they each dropped off a lander and, in a major innovation, a weather balloon that floated in the planet's atmosphere for 2 days, transmitting data. After deploying their Venus assets, the main spacecraft used a gravity assist to continue their journey and intercept Halley's Comet, forming a key part of the international Halley Armada, and returning the first-ever images of a comet's nucleus. Mars, a decades-long effort marked by heartbreaking failure. The Soviets launched dozens of probes towards Mars, but the program was plagued by launch failures, in-transit communication losses, and landing crashes. While they achieved some partial successes, such as the Mars 3 orbiter and the very brief transmission from its lander, they never achieved the sustained success they had at Venus. The later Phobos missions to Mars's moon also failed, making Mars the great unconquered prize of the Soviet program. Phobos, a highly ambitious but ultimately failed late Soviet attempt to explore Mars and its moon, Phobos. The twin Phobos, 1 and 2 spacecraft, were designed to orbit Mars and deploy long-lived landers onto the surface of Phobos. The program was a heartbreaking failure. Phobos 1 was lost en route to Mars due to a single incorrect command from ground control. Phobos 2 successfully reached Mars orbit and gathered data, but contact was lost just before it was scheduled to deploy its Phobos landers. Zond. The secret crewed circumlunar program. While the public saw unmanned Zond probes flying around the moon, these were actually uncrewed test flights of the Soyuz 7KL-1 spacecraft, designed to carry two cosmonauts on a lunar flyby. The program was intended to beat the American Apollo 8 mission. After several successful uncrewed flights, including carrying tortoises around the moon, major failures with the Proton rocket and the realization that the system was too unreliable for a human crew led to its cancellation. N1L3, the Soviet Crewed Lunar Landing Program. This was the direct competitor to Apollo, a massive top-secret effort to land a cosmonaut on the moon. The program centered on the colossal N1, the largest rocket ever built by the Soviets. The entire program was a catastrophic failure. All four uncrewed test launches of the N1 rocket between 1969 and 1972 ended in spectacular explosions, with one destroying the entire launch complex. The failure of the N1 rocket was the single biggest reason the Soviet Union lost the race to the moon. Soyuz, the workhorse of human spaceflight. Originally designed for the lunar program, the Soyuz spacecraft proved to be an incredibly reliable and versatile vehicle. Following the end of the moon race, it became the primary ferry for carrying cosmonauts to space stations. Despite early tragedies, the program has flown for over 50 years with constant upgrades, making it the longest-running and most successful human spaceflight program in history. Interkosmos, the Soviet Union's space diplomacy program. Interkosmos was an international cooperative effort that allowed non-Soviet cosmonauts, primarily from socialist and allied nations like Czechoslovakia, Poland, France, and India, to fly on Soyuz missions. These guest cosmonauts would travel to the Salyut and later Mir space stations, conducting experiments and symbolizing political partnership. It was the Soviet answer to international cooperation and a powerful tool of soft power during the Cold War. Salyut, the world's first space stations. After losing the moon race, the Soviets pivoted to long-duration spaceflight. The Salyut program was a series of seven stations launched throughout the 1970s and 80s. These were single-module stations, split between civilian labs that set early endurance records and top-secret Almaz military reconnaissance stations, which were equipped with cameras and even a cannon. This program was the crucial learning ground for living and working in space. Almaz, the top-secret military space station program. While the world knew about the civilian Salyut stations, the Soviet military was simultaneously running its own program called Almaz. To disguise their purpose, these heavily modified military reconnaissance stations were launched and publicly given Salyut designations. They were equipped with powerful spy cameras, radar systems, and, famously, a fixed aircraft cannon for self-defense, making them the first and only armed crewed military outposts in space. Mir, the first modular space station. Launched in 1986, Mir was the culmination of everything learned from Salyut. A core module was launched first, and over the next decade, five more science modules were added, creating a large, complex orbital outpost. Mir held the record for the longest continuous human presence in space for many years and hosted international astronauts, including Americans, after the fall of the USSR. It was the crowning achievement of the Soviet space station effort. Buran, the Soviet space shuttle. Developed in response to the American program, Buran was a visually similar reusable space plane, but it was launched on the separate Super Heavy Lift Energia rocket. In a remarkable feat, Buran was designed to be fully automated. It performed a single, flawless, uncrewed test flight in 1988, orbiting the Earth and performing a perfect automated landing. However, due to immense costs and the collapse of the Soviet Union, the program was canceled before it could ever fly with a crew. Proton. This was not a single program with one goal, but a designation for a series of large, heavy scientific satellites launched by the powerful Proton rocket. After the rocket was proven, it was used to launch a number of uncrewed observatories into high Earth orbit. These Proton satellites carried massive experiments to study high-energy astrophysics and cosmic rays, missions that were too heavy for smaller launchers. Kosmos, the public name for hundreds of secret missions. Kosmos was not a single program, but a generic designation used to hide the true nature of a wide variety of satellites. This name was given to everything from military spy satellites and navigation systems to failed planetary probes that never left Earth orbit and prototypes for new spacecraft. If a satellite was military, experimental, or had failed, it was simply given the next number in the Kosmos series, obscuring its real purpose from the world. Thanks for watching. Which Soviet program do you think had the biggest impact on space exploration? Let me know your thoughts. Please also remember to like and subscribe if you enjoyed this video.